This is A Bit of Biology with Mr. Rock. Today we are going to talk about the central dogma again. We talked about it in one video, and this is actually going to be the sequel. So the first video was about transcription. This video is going to be part two, and it is about translation. Just a reminder of what the central dogma is. Another name for it is protein synthesis. And what it's about is taking DNA and making it into proteins. And the reason why we need to do this is because proteins are going to be the building blocks for life. So no matter what kind of living organism you are, we are all made up of proteins, and we got those proteins from our DNA. So the two different steps, like I said, transcription, there's a video on that. If you have not seen that, I would recommend watching that before you watch this video. Transcription is making RNA from DNA, but this video is really all about translation, which is making protein from the RNA that we made in transcription. So the end goal here is to make protein. Where we left off with the last video, we knew that we made an mRNA strand. The reason why is because DNA cannot leave the nucleus. So we had to make an mRNA strand to send a message out into the cytoplasm where it could be made into protein. So that's where we're leaving off right now, is we have an mRNA strand. It is now in the cytoplasm, and it's ready to be made into protein. So the important questions about translation are, what is translation? Like I've said before, translation is protein, making proteins from an mRNA strand. When does it happen? It occurs after transcription. Where is a great question. In transcription took place in the nucleus. Now, we are in the cytoplasm with translation, and this is done by the ribosomes. So the ribosomes are the protein factories for the cell, and we need to make protein, so obviously we need some ribosomes. And the reason why we're doing this, like I've said too, proteins are the building blocks for life. Since in this video I'm going to be talking a lot about protein, it's important for you to understand what an amino acid is. An amino acid is just one part of a large protein. It is the monomer. Amino acids are the monomer. Proteins are the polymer. So in this video, we're going to be making amino acid chains. So down here in this image, this is one amino acid. And there's lots of them together. This is an amino acid chain. And amino acid chain equals a protein, and that's what we're trying to make. Some new terms that I need you to understand. The first would be tRNA. I put a star on this, and I would like you to do the same. tRNA is what it does is it transfers an amino acid and an anticodon to the ribosome. The second type of RNA that we're dealing with is ribosomal RNA. And when we did organelles a couple units back, you actually didn't know this, but the ribosome itself is actually made up of RNA. And that type of RNA is called ribosomal or rRNA. Finally, the last definition we have here is anticodon, a three-letter tRNA strand that binds with a codon. One thing I just want to say, I know all of this information here is really brand new, and it might not make that much sense at all. I'm going to show some images, I'm going to show some steps, and hopefully it starts coming together. Before we can talk about translation, the process at least, or the drawing, or what an anticodon is, we got to understand first what a codon is. So with the mRNA strand that we made in transcription, that's going to be sent into the cytoplasm. Now, when the ribosome gets on to an mRNA strand and it's going to start making proteins from it, It's going to read the mRNA at three letters at a time. So the three letters it reads is called a codon. So it's three letters of an mRNA strand. That's what a codon is. And the codons are going to be used to determine what amino acid comes next. So there's going to be a whole chain of codons, and that's going to dictate what amino acid is used. So a couple of interesting things about this. Number one, the start codon to begin translation is AUG. And then there are three stop codons. There's UAA, UAG, and UGA. Now down here I have practice for you. One thing a skill that you have to have is you need to be able to use this table here on the right, and you have to use your codon to find your amino acid, and you need to know how to do that. So I'm going to show you how right now. We have different places for a codon. So over here we have first, the second, and the third letter. So the way that this is going to work is you're going to use this table over here on the right, and you're going to see the letter C. And right here it says first letter. So our first letter is C, our second letter is A. So what that means is C, I come across. A, I come down. And then our last letter is U. So that means U, this is our third one over here. And I kind of covered it up, and I apologize about that. But our amino acid is his or histidine. So you could try to find AAC by yourself. I'll also do it up here. Maybe you're working ahead of me, but AAC, so try to find that. You want to find your amino acid. First letter's A, brings us across. We come down to A. And our amino acid is ASN. So that's how you use the table to find your amino acid. And we're going to have to do that here. So some things that I would like to say before I show you the pictures of translation. One, anytime you are making translation happen, so you're taking an mRNA and you're turning it into proteins, which are amino acids, you do not start translation until you see the AUG. So you don't start until you see the AUG. So then you're going to go down a strand and you see CAC, and that's histamine, sorry. And then you're going to go all the way until you see a stop codon. And the stop codons are down here. So once again, they're UAA, UAG, and UGA. And this is UGA, and that's why we're going to stop there. So let's talk about the steps of translation then, now that we kind of understand what a codon is. Step one is going to be the ribosome meets mRNA at the codon AUG. That's the start codon. That's where we're going to begin. This is a new step here. So step two, tRNA brings in the anticodon with the amino acid. And I'll show you in the next slide what the anticodon is. Step three, the ribosome is going to move down the mRNA while the amino acid chain grows. So the amino acid chain is going to get longer and longer, and that's how we make a protein. And we are going to do this until you hit that stop codon. So until you hit UGA. And once you hit that, translation ends, and then you have your protein at the end. So here we go. A couple of things that I want to explain right away. The blue circle is going to be your ribosome. And what comes in right away is the anticodon. So this is the anticodon, UAC, and it matches up with the start codon, which is AUG. So the base pair rule still works. A goes to U, U goes to A, G goes to C. And the anticodon brings the amino acid with it. So it's going to bring MET, the amino acid methionine, and it's going to bring it, and it's going to start making the amino acid chain. The ribosome is going to move down because we hit the start codon. So here we go. It's kind of like a cartoon or a comic. We're making our amino acid chain. So we're moving down. This is our anticodon. Blue circle is the ribosome. It brought PRO, proline, the amino acid, and it attaches to the amino acid chain. We're going to go to the next picture. The ribosome is moving down. The anticodon pairs up with the codon GCA, and it brings in alanine. And we're almost finished now. So the blue circle, that's still the ribosome. The red letters are still the anticodon, and they are pairing up A to U, G to C, G to C. And now we are making an amino acid chain. It's getting longer. And then finally, we've reached the end. Once again, blue circle, still the ribosome. UAG tells us to stop. We're stopping translation. And we did it. That was the purpose, everything we just did. So we brought the tRNA in, it matched up the anticodon and the codon. And also with the anticodon, we got the amino acid. So we made this long amino acid chain, and this is a protein, and this was the whole entire purpose of everything that we've been doing. We wanted to make protein with the ribosomes. And I'm gonna scoot that up so you can't pause it. Okay, so what I want you to do now is I want you to do transcription, and then I also want you to do translation. So, starting off with transcription. We did this in the last video. You're pairing up the letters A to U, C to G, T to A, and G to C. One step that I enjoy doing is I really like breaking it up into codons. So, remember, you do not start translating until you find AUG. So you actually don't need to worry about these letters at all. So find AUG, and then I like to break it up into three-letter parts, and remember those three letters are the codon. This next step is a little tricky. This is the tRNA. These are the anticodons as well. So this is the anticodon. It only brings the amino acid, but when we go to make our amino acid chain, you make the amino acid chain based off of the mRNA. So when you use that table, when you use the table, you use the mRNA. You do not use the tRNA. The tRNA is just the anticodon. So please do not be confused by that. So one thing I want you to try is I would like you to try to take your DNA, transcribe it, so make it into mRNA, do the anticodons, but then at the end get your amino acids. I'm going to pause. You could go ahead and pause the video here. One thing I'll pull up is your table. So put it on pause, try to do this on your own, and then press play when you're ready for the answer. Okay. This is the answer. This is transcription and translation for that DNA strand up there. My reminder, if you got the answer wrong, is remember, we do not use the tRNA. We do not use the tRNA to make the amino acids. Once again, I have green arrows coming down, but you use the mRNA to decide what amino acid we are going to use. You do not start until you hit AUG, and you stop once you hit UAA. And you read them three letters at a time. This last image, I just really like this image because it's a good picture of what we did here in the central dogma. So step one was transcription. We're locked inside the nucleus. We have to unzip the DNA and turn it into mRNA. That mRNA is a message that's going to be sent into the cytoplasm. So it's going to come out into the cytoplasm. And ribosomes are going to read it, and with that, we are going to make our amino acid chain. And this step right here is called translation, and that's what this video was about. This has been a large bit of biology with Mr. Rock. I'm signing off.